सारे जो जितने बैग है सब
Yes, the number could increase at this point in time. As we speak, the number is constantly increasing. Several other schools are also reporting that they had this threat that came in this morning. I have a parent with me, ma'am. Excuse me. Ma'am, एक second. आप यहीं पर हैं, live पर हैं, ma'am. आपके बच्चे यहाँ पे, ma'am. क्या हुआ था? और school ने क्या बोला था?
सर, स्कूल से अर्ली मॉर्निंग एक मैसेज आया था. उसके अंदर ये लगता है कि स्कूल के अंदर यहाँ पे एक बॉम्ब का मैसेज आया है. ये सर, ये मेरे स्कूल से भी मैसेजेस आ रहे हैं. तो ये मैसेज आया था कि आपका एक स्कूल के बच्चे हैं तो लेके जाइए यहाँ से. ये तो इसलिए मैं अपने बच्चों को फिर यहाँ से लेके चली गई.
आपके बच्चे यहाँ से लेकर कितने बजे मैसेज आया था मैम अप्रॉक्सीमेटली?
सर, सुबह 7:30 के अराउंड मैसेज आ गया था. ये 7:15 का उसका टाइम होता है. ये
अभी कोई अपडेट आया स्कूल?
सर, अभी से कोई अपडेट नहीं है, कुछ भी नहीं. अभी कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं है, कोई मैसेजेज नहीं है स्कूल से, कोई कुछ नहीं हो रहा. अभी कोई टच नहीं है. ये thank you so much.
So yes, I'll just try and show you in the visuals over here. Parents are constantly coming over here. They have taken their wards back to their homes, but this is Mother Mary School out here in East Delhi, and as we speak, the number of schools that are reporting such emails is constantly increasing. More than 10 schools have officially reported that they have received these bomb threats, whereas what sources are telling us that in specific districts such as the Dwarka district, 6 to 7 schools have already reported that they have received these emails. 2 to 3 schools in Noida have also reported that they have received these emails. In fact, in the national capital itself, more than 10 schools have already said that they have received these emails. All these schools are being evacuated. Bomb squads, fire squads, all of them have reached on the spot. This school has been evacuated. Search operations are still underway. It remains to be seen as to what is the truth behind these emails. What sources in the Delhi police are telling us that it is from the same email that this mail has been sent to all these schools. The IP address has been masked, and that is the reason why it is getting very, very difficult for the Delhi police to actually trace from where this email had originated. So yes, it remains to be seen how quickly can the Delhi police now make sure that the perpetrator of this crime, the person who has sent out these emails, can be brought to the books. But yes, at this point in time, definitely there is a sense of panic that can be sensed amongst the locals and the parents as well, who are coming in out here and inquiring from these schools as to what is happening at this point in time. Well, at this point in time, the modus operandi is different, because remember, initially when such bomb calls were reported, there were specific schools who had received these emails. Now this time around, more than 10 schools have already reported that they have received these emails. They have told the police, and in fact evacuation operation at all these schools are underway. In fact, in Dwarka itself, at least 6 to 7 schools have reported that they have received these bomb threats. Out here in the East district where I am standing in Mayur Vihar, one school, that is the Mother Mary school, has reported that it has received bomb threats. In Noida as well, one school in Noida, DPS Noida, and in Greater Noida, KP Public School in Greater Noida, has also reported that they have received the bomb threats. So definitely, this is a new modus operandi that can be seen at this point in time. Several schools have been sent this email. What the police suspects at this point in time, that the person who had sent out this email could be just one person, and the email ID is being traced down. But yes, the IP address has been masked for that email ID, and that is the reason why it is becoming very, very difficult for the police to actually trace from where did that email originate. Did that originate from within the country or outside the country? Also, what police are telling, sources are telling us, that VPN was also used while these emails were being sent out. So definitely, it has the entire thing has been done in a very, very planned manner out here in the national capital. So yes, it remains to be seen how quickly can the person who has sent out this such emails to a lot of schools out here in the national capital can be traced and nabbed. But yes, at this point in time, as we speak, more and more schools are coming up, more and more, the number is increasing by every passing minute. It remains to be seen as to how many schools have received such emails, and also it remains to be seen as to who is the person who has sent out this email in bulk to private schools out here in the national capital region. Well, this is going to be a very uphill task for the Delhi police, because remember, a VPN has been used. Not only the VPN, but the email ID has also been masked by the by the perpetrator. So definitely it is going to be very, very difficult for the Delhi police to actually go ahead and make sure that the person who has sent out this email can be nabbed. It is going to be a very, very long process, very, very long haul for the Delhi police to eventually track that person down, unmask that email ID and unmask the remove the VPN, and then eventually somewhere the IP address can be traced, because that is the only way that the police can go ahead and find that person. Over the last 1 year, we have seen that 4 to 5 schools had reported such calls, but none of the accused were arrested in either of these schools. This actually tells an entire story as to how difficult is the job for the police to make sure that the email ID is traced down, the IP address is traced down. So yes, it remains to be seen if that will happen this time around, because the emails are sent out in bulk. More than 10 schools have already reported. More schools are coming up. More schools are informing the police that they have also received similar emails from that email ID. So definitely it is going to be a very, very big task, a very uphill task for the Delhi police to make sure that the person who has sent out this email can be brought to the books. Interestingly, Toya, yesterday itself, a lot of hospitals out here in the national capital had received similar emails, but definitely all those emails eventually became hoax email, because nothing was found in those hospitals. Now on the similar lines, we are seeing that a lot of schools today are receiving these emails. It remains to be seen if at all these emails are hoax emails, or if there is something that could be found out over here. I'll just try and show you in the visuals around the school as well. You can see that there is police that has entered the school. The police is actually trying, search operations are underway inside these schools from approximately over the last two hours itself. So yes, it remains to be seen if at all anything could be found out by the police. But definitely the manner in which these emails have been sent out in bulk has definitely sent shockwaves across the national capital, and has definitely spread panic amongst the parents whose children had just come to the school, and suddenly the school informs them that due to some emergency they will have to return back. So yes, it remains to be seen eventually how will things pan out, but definitely the manner in which this incident has happened is definitely very, very shocking, and it's definitely a cause of concern for the Delhi police, who is now trying to find out as to who is the person who has sent out this email to a lot of schools out here in the national capital.
Delhi police's teams evacuating students from across schools here in Delhi NCR. About 50 schools have received bomb threats in Delhi NCR, forcing students to be moved out of the school premises at the earliest. These schools are spread across Delhi, Noida and other parts of Delhi NCR. Most of them received emails which said that there was a threat. It turned out to be a hoax, but as a precaution, most of the schools sent back their students home early. This is not the first time that such an incident has been reported in Delhi NCR or in other parts of the country. Earlier also in Delhi schools, such hoax emails or phone calls were received, and it turned out to be somebody who was playing a prank. Similar incident happened in Bangalore also. So this is turning out to be a huge menace for the law enforcing authorities here. Essentially, what they are trying to ascertain is, as the investigation is proceeding, as to who really is sending these emails, what is it that the person who's sending these emails is wanting. Is there any kind of malafide intent, or is it just a prank, which is the worst kind of prank that one can think of? Police is trying to ascertain the IP address from where the emails really came, but at this stage there seems to be panic all over Delhi NCR, where parents have had to rush in after Delhi police decided to carry out a precautionary evacuation in schools across Delhi NCR. Like I said, more than 24 such schools received emails, and some of them, as a matter of precaution, decided to send their children back home.